So, Amy, I'm not trying to say I told you so, but did you see Shannon Watts's tweet yesterday that said, like, only, you know, 360 days to 2022?
I did, and it made me laugh. And there's also this meme going around the internet that's making me laugh, which is like, 6 days in, 2021 said to 2020, hold my beer. It's so funny. And like, I actually am so grateful that you prepared me many months ago, but I could not blame all of this in 2020, because like I walked into 2021, like, this is not over. This is not changing. Like the calendar doesn't mean anything right now. But I mean, but you're so right. I think the world was like, okay, 2020 is over. Let's move on. And I'm like, let's dig in. Cause this is, I mean, I'm laughing, but it's a shit show.
Well, you know, I mean, it's funny because we feel better, as my daughter Ella tells me, it's a coping mechanism. That's why people kept saying, I can't wait for 2021. But, you know, I always say like the year my mom died was the same year my book came out, and the same year my daughter and I took a really incredible trip together to London. Like, I feel like when you demonize a year, you also lose the great moments. And so it's better to just separate time from our experiences, because I mean, my little Buddha is Bowen, and you know that, my 10-year-old, but the other day he was going to bed and he goes, time is a social construct. It's not really anything beyond that. And I'm like, oh my God, Bowen, that's really true. But it's something we've made up, right? He's like, it didn't even used to exist, that concept of a year, the way we think about it now. And I think it's so true. So I think we're so much better off. I used to get so sad as a parent when I would see kids, you know, having a temper tantrum at 11 a.m. at a birthday party, right? Because birthday parties start so early. So it's like 11 to 1 was like the ideal birthday party when my kids were little, because you could have lunch at 12 and then they're going home to nap or whatever it is, right? I mean, those are the years you're in. And at 11 a.m., the kid would have a temper tantrum and the parent would be like, we're going to leave because Johnny's having a really bad day. And you're like, but it's only 11. Like, by 2, you know, probably in 2 minutes, Johnny's going to be fine. So like, why are you going to leave the party? Like, these things, I think sometimes we like to assign bad day, bad week, bad month. Yeah. And it's so much healthier when we just think, okay, every day, even the best days of your life, Amy, something shitty happened. It's just.
No. Oh, I completely agree. And I think like I, as you know, like in for my entire life, I've been somebody who's kind of like relentlessly moving forward, and I've been really optimistic and everything. And, you know, this year has been, or the past 9 months, not this year, but the past, since COVID started, it's been really hard. It's impacted my business. It's impacted my life. And I've been, you know, dealing with some depression, and I think it's situational, but what I've realized is like, when I wake up, if I feel down, I'm like, okay, I might not feel down in 4 hours. Right. Like, I'm not going to be like, this is a lost day. Okay. I don't force myself to try to get out of it, but I kind of just keep moving. Yeah. And I think like in a meta sense, we have to do that in the world. We have to be like, okay, on January 6th, there was an insurrection, and that doesn't mean that our country is doomed. It means that we need to keep looking forward and figuring out like, there is hope, things can change. And
by the way, Amy, I just want to point out, on January 6th, we also flipped the Senate. So I mean,
it's crazy.
Like, there were a few thousand insane white supremacists. And obviously that is a part of our country that is shameful and horrific. And we've got to do our best to diminish those voices. However, at the same time, we made history with the first Black senator from Georgia, the first Jewish senator from Georgia. Like, the world is changing. And so I think it's a shame not to also celebrate those moments.
I completely agree. I mean, and not just like, you know, Senator-elect Ossoff's father was an immigrant, and Senator Warnock's mother picked cotton in fields in Georgia.
I mean, that's
America.
I posted on Facebook, why can't we celebrate that? And I got a lot of people going, yes, I love you for saying that. And then I got some people who were like, this is so tone deaf. This is a horrible day in American history. But I was really trying to say, like, of course these are horrible things, but we shouldn't take away our celebration too. It's really tricky.
You know what this, I think, like, you bring up Bowen, and I think I go to my Reese, who's my kind of sage, she's 4. And she was starting a new school program this week. And the night before, I said, how do you feel? And she said, I feel nervous and excited. And I was like, yes, an and is okay. And I think that's a really cool way to
look at it. I love that. I love that. Thank you, Reese, for that those words of wisdom. Because I actually, Amy, I love what you said. An and is okay. It's like with your feelings, it's okay to have an and. I love that.
Yeah.
Right. Bye, everyone. Words of wisdom. Bye.